Alrighty then. Here we are. Just gonna dip into VR for just a minute. A matter of fact, I'm actually gonna cheat a little bit here. Make sure everything's good. Then we're gonna use the old, well, maybe I am. I'm in the right window. The thing with VR, one of the many, is that if you're not in the right window, you may not even know it. Okay, get a little gas.
The engine needs a little more prime. The engine seems ideally primed.
That's the instructor that comes with this aircraft. And I don't usually cheat him, because I do actually enjoy it. This is the aerofoil Cessna 172 Skyhawk. And I mean, this thing is fully outfitted. Got a couple chiquitas in the back. We're ready to roll on our little mission here. What I've done is I've just kind of dicked around with the scenery a little bit to make sure everything's free. Everything is free. That's the only thing that doesn't work. Look at that little screw up down there. It takes a bit of animation, though. I'm not going to blame them for that. Not right now, because I'm too in love with the aircraft. All right. Bring everything up. Let's flip a bitch. This scenery, actually. And we'll go around this way just to show this off a little bit in VR. Because, you know, I mean, this is for an older scenery, too. This isn't, like, something brand new. But I have been thoroughly amazed. They're waiting for a ride, but I'm not here to give them a ride. So. Thoroughly amazed, though, at what this has to offer. Now again, this is for entertainment. I'm starting to goof around with some modifications I want to do in the future. And this is just messing around with the technologies. And actually, I don't even have an animation for this. This little thing that I put out here for us to go find. I just want you to look though. Gravel and everything. Take a minute to enjoy this. This is an absolutely amazing scenery set. It was cheap too. I think it's $20 or less. But for small aircraft and flying in these really detailed models, this is really the best scenery you could be doing things like this with. I think you're going to be chopping treetops off and having a good time with this. Alright. Enjoy ourselves. Like I said, I'm not following any particular rules. Just kind of doing my thing. So actually, I'm going to go over here to the right. Playing this river. Going down there to the valley, ranch off the side of the highway where I left a little Easter egg of something I got off of a 3D warehouse. And I just decided I'd figure my way through the act of converting it, bringing it into an actual simulator and enjoy it. The mountains are absolutely amazing. Fishing. The only thing I can say is they're using a few of the speed trees that I don't like. They're too mossy in some respects. You get up into the mountains though, and they're using some of the speed trees that are on the rocks. They just don't work. Just wondering how the reflections are. they're simple, they're easy to throw in here. I've got quite a few that I put in really low poly that look good from all angles. Just play around in here and have a good time. I figure once some of the folks that play some of this stuff with me will get a chance to get upgraded and get some of these nifty sceneries here. Create some videos of us flying together. Maybe doing some search and rescue missions based on this scenery that I just think it makes a great way of training. Wake up Armordale down here and spits up. Get to him. It's by the highway there. So I think what we're going to do is we're gonna get a little width here on the descent. Or speed where we're at. Make sure my mouse. Let's see. Let's see here. It's gonna be my best option. I think we'll have to take a walk. I think we've got a lot of trees to do. I'm not seeing it. I guess with this particular model, I could have even done the little deal. I landed a little sooner than I needed to. Fences. I mean, even the dumb fences. So I think what I'm gonna do is put up here. The furnace we can turn around. I just want to take one of these down. Okay. So this time I think we're just gonna goof around here a little bit. It out, so yeah, we try to be righteous. The textures are actually looking pretty good on. This is one thing I really hate, and I'm gonna have to figure this out, is the walking effect on this. It has got to be one of the dumbest things, and I've seen people who've gotten it right. So cool. All I gotta do is get through the fence. There we go. Actually, other than the back texture being non-existent, for which I have no idea why the bottom's down, it's kind of a complicated model though. I'm actually surprised my little Martian friend here actually looks as good as it does. They've come a long way since X10. I mean, X10 could do some groovy stuff, but even the textures on that are really good. Yeah, little buddy, looks like you need some ibuprofen though. It'd probably eat you alive or something. So, it is as I suspected. So, sometimes what rendering engines do is they replace one texture for another. So, the reflection here is causing an error, which is see-through. This is kind of a cute little model here. Like the little piece of that windshield there. And this is actually a pretty cool little piece of stuff. Am I actually seeing through it? Am I seeing the reflection? I think I'm seeing through it. Because if I'm right, there's a little building over here. Looks like that. So like what I was saying is it's just getting the reflections wrong. The reflection's inverted. It's usually a counted texture issue. Hey, but what do I know? Yeah. Looks like our little friend over here has really had a tough landing. Here we are to greet him, right? He's a cute little model, too. Let's see here. So, And I don't like X-Plane 11's contrails that come off the back of high-flying aircraft. Makes me think of like something out of Harry Potter. I expect to get up there at altitude and find some dumbass on a broom. I got my things, but I'll tell you, even compared to X-Plane compared to Prepared, I just dig the heck out of the models and everything here. Realism is a lot better. That's unfortunate too. I can't even get back because this particular fly inside won't allow you to do anything with the Hey, there's a screenshot. Woohoo! Well, this fly inside deal, it won't deal with cameras very well. Let's see what we look like. Am I still in there? The thing I like about these 3D people, too, is they're active. They don't just sit there. Of being screwy in a game like this. It's taken back off. Maybe a little Argo 3. I've been in here a lot lately. getting my TV on the spot. I do care more about this. Airspeed. Let her sink on her own now. Because really the taxiway's up there a little ways, and oh that was hard. Still though, I'd land like that. I'd pitch it myself, but I'd be alright. Mostly I want to get on the ground, show off a little more scenery over here, this little ranch. I've got to get a lot of my key stuff done. Now that I have this, I'm a little more inspired to spend time and get this right. I've actually got all of the professional grade models for the stuff we need. For instance, UAVs with FLIR cameras on them and everything for this. So that took me about 3 weeks to find what I needed and develop what I needed to do add-ons. And now I've got remote controllable up to a 4 mile radius on regular radio and unlimited on the cellular network, which is what we'll use in real life. But imagine being able to take and train people on remote reconnaissance using common UAV drones. And that's what I've kind of put together. Let's see if it works for us well enough. And by the way, the model pack that these guys are using, or did use, is fairly freely available. It's pretty easy to find. Throw that brake. Get rid of that. Really?
The engine seems ideally primed.
I like that. If you heard what he said, the engine seems ideally primed. And with that, I think we're primed. We've had a good flight. We are done and out of here. Just come up here to order that.